Hello all, I am Amol Choudhury from the Department of ENTC Engineering of AISSMS IIT Pune. In this video, I am demonstrating the practical of porting of Linux on ARM9 microcontroller and to execute simple application.
Students, the practical that we have to perform for porting of Linux on ARM9 microcontroller, the steps which we have dictated in particular lab manual. So we will see the demonstration of those particular steps. First, I will go in the Linux folder, and from the Linux folder, I will locate my hello folder, and over there will be the main.c file. You can create main.c file from text editor as well, or what you can do, you can locate this file in Linux and then subfolder hello. Once you will open this, over here you will have to write a program to print a simple message like hello world or any of the string that you want to display. Suppose I will type that particular program. So suppose I have typed this particular program, which will simply write a message or simply print a message, let's say hello RTOS students, and thereafter I will save this particular program, and now it is being saved in the main.c file. After writing this particular C program in main.c file, now what I will do, I will open the command prompt. Before opening the command prompt, please look at the files, that config.in, hello.mk, the main.c in which we have written C program, main.o, makefile, and std_types.h. These are nothing but the files which we have in the hello subfolder. Then I will open this particular command prompt, and now what I will do, I will, from this particular command prompt, now I will go in this folder like where I have saved my main.c file. So from here I will go into home, cd is for change directory, home. From home I have IOIT folder, in IOIT I have desktop folder, and in desktop I am having Linux folder, thereafter I am having hello folder, and in that particular hello folder I am having main.c file. So this is one path at which I am having my main.c file. So I will type this particular path and then I will click on enter. Now I am in that particular folder where I am having main.c file. So for compilation, first I will type main make clean, and then I will click enter, and after this I will simply type make. So this will create the executable file, and you can see this executable file which is in violet color, and so name of that file is hello. Okay, so this file was not present at the few seconds before. So this file we have created after the compilation process. Now students, once this executable file hello is created, you have to copy it and go in home folder, and over here you will find this tftp boot folder. So double click on it and just paste your executable file in the hello folder. So this is an important step, do not forget to do this step. So I will simply type sudo minicom. Okay, it will ask for the password. The password is provided in the lab manual. So I will type that particular password, and now this is the minicom terminal which is being opened over here. So this is the minicom terminal with which we will have the communication between host system and the target system. Okay. Now I will simply click on the reset button. And what I will do, I will simply press Ctrl C button when these messages are appearing. Okay. And to download the particular file system image and the Z system image, so the commands are provided in our lab manual. So these are the commands. So one by one, I will type these commands in the Minicom terminal. So students, please remember, these are the commands which we are typing in the Minicom terminal. So this is for serial communication between host system and the target. So for this demonstration purpose, I will simply use these commands. So ramdisk.gz is nothing but my file system image. Okay, so it is asking me an image name ramdisk.gz exist. So do you want to overwrite? Yes, we want to overwrite. So I will simply type Y for yes. Okay, now our file system image is successfully, we have given the commands for the same. And now what I will do, I will type the commands so that we will able to download the kernel image. So last command is this. So it will again ask Z image already exists. So I will press Y. Now, after this red boot command prompt has been appeared on the screen, what I will do, I will press the reset button from the kit. So students, this is ARM9 development board. You can see on your screen, this is the Ethernet connection, that one end of this Ethernet cable is connected to this Ethernet port and the other end of this cable is connected to the CPU of the particular PC. This is what power supply cable, and this is the cable for RS232 serial communication. So for reset operation, I will press this particular button. So once reset button is pressed, it will give some messages that you are seeing on the screen, like uncompressing Linux and compressed image is found at block 0. And if you have typed the command correctly, then it will show you one particular message. So, hello world is the message that gives the confirmation that file system image and the kernel image has been successfully downloaded on the ARM9 microcontroller. Then as per the message, please press enter to activate this console. So I will press enter button from the keyboard. And now students, to execute the Hello World application, now the command which I have to type, that I will type now. Now students, to run our main.c file, in which we have written a program to print a message hello art of students, we need to enter commands. First command is tftp space dash g space dash r space hello and IP address of the host. Then click enter, then command chmod 777 hello and thereafter ./filename, that is hello, and click enter. So this is the output of the first practical of Linux. Hello Arto students, in which first we have written a C program in main.c file, then we have compiled it using the terminal that is we are having in Linux operating system with commands make clean and make. Then whatever executable file is created, that we have copied into the tftp folder. We have opened the terminal minicom using command sudo minicom, and from that first we have typed the command for downloading file system image. Thereafter we have typed command for downloading Linux kernel image, and once that particular commands are typed, and thereafter we have simply resetted the kit. We have reset the kit, and thereafter we have to execute our application. We have used these three commands.
I hope you have understood the steps to perform porting of Linux on ARM9 microcontroller and how to execute a simple application. Thank you.